Yeah, well, the cool thing is you're never going to run out of content to put out, Sebastian, because you're making videos at the developer level that developers need to look at. But if you do everything right, you're going to put me out of YouTube because I won't need to do videos on how to do stuff. It'll just be so easy a couple years from now that people will be like, why is he making a video about it? I don't need to make a video about how to use a Visa credit card, right? You know, they're just too easy to use. put me out of a job, man.
That's the long-term vision, right? But you have to remember that I was doing a video on kind of cryptocurrency adoption, saying I shouldn't be afraid to go out and, you know, spend a little bit of cryptocurrency just once in a blue moon and buy some coffee or something like that. And you know, it's kind of I feel like there's a parallel of like where Starbucks, for example, might be accepting Bitcoin within the year. They're not going to hold the Bitcoin. It'll be run through Bakkt, which is obviously the big project being launched right now by the Intercontinental Exchange, which is the owner of the New York Stock Exchange and 12 other major global stock exchanges. And so you think about like Starbucks, and like not a lot of people are going to come in at the start, right? But people, as they learn how to use it, if you guys think back to like the 90s, right? And I remember like, you know, like Mac cards and stuff like this. So like that early phase of technology, right? There was a learning curve, and we forget about the learning curve now because it's become so intuitive and such a large part of our lives. But there was definitely a learning curve. I mean, there was a time when you'd go in with a, you know, with a card and they would, you know, swipe it on those big carbon copy machines and stuff like that, right? Because they didn't have the infrastructure set up technologically yet. And so I think there's going to be a lot of business still for us to do in terms of making educational videos to talk about people about the technology and how to build things on top of that technology, as well as simply how to use it. And it's becoming more and more intuitive all the time, but still.
Yeah, there'll always be content to make, because even once actually using crypto becomes easier, what will then become necessary is, what are all these different applications that it's used for and how do you use it? You know, that's there's always going to be stuff to do for making these YouTube videos. And I do want to give a little bit of a shout out of an idea for our other crypto YouTubers, at least in the Cardano region. We've got a couple of guys, Barry from Barry TV, Adasaur, Crypto Secret Circle, Sugar Zeus Crypto, a couple other guys. Hashoshi, he's really good with these videos too. He's got a couple of Cardano related videos out there. So I just wanted to give a shout out to those guys making Cardano related videos. And at some point we need to do a get together with those guys, or, you know, and have them come on the program and do a very similar program to what we're doing right now. What do you guys think of that? Would that be pretty cool?
That sounds good. That sounds good. We're all ambassadors here, so we're trying to have an ambassador related episode where more of the Cardano ambassadors can be featured. So that would be great in the future. So Lark, I wanted to switch to something else. Since you are a very experienced YouTuber and you are involved with a lot of communities, like Rick, Sebastian, and I, we're pretty much Cardano related, so we eat, sleep, and breathe just Cardano. But you know, you're involved with a lot of different communities, you've seen a lot of communities over time, and you know, I have a question from one of my friends. His name is Marcus, so shout out to Marcus. And in your opinion, is there anything that makes the Cardano community unique? It could be positive or negative compared to other cryptocurrency communities that you've seen formed around certain popular projects that you've interacted with. Is there something special about the Cardano community, or it could be positive or negative. It's fine.
That's a great question, actually. And I think the Cardano community overall is incredibly positive. And obviously what's being built and things is really exciting too. And I feel like with Cardano, it's perhaps maybe a more mature community. And it's hard to say. I mean, the communities are so big, but you can definitely look at some cryptocurrency communities. You can really see that kind of a large trend of sort of immature moon boy Lambo kind of stuff. And it sounds so cliche, but honestly, I go into some Reddits and I'm just like, oh my God, what is going on in here? And others are not like that at all. And I think it says a lot about the leads behind the project, that they are out there being very professional and And in terms of Cardano, where it is right now, I mean, there's a lot of people who look at it and like, okay, I'm going to make a lot of money off this investment. But there's also a lot of people who look and are understanding the tech. And I feel like they're the foundation of that community right now. People who are looking and trying to understand the tech, or at least they're trying to understand the implications of the tech and understanding the implications of what's being built. And I feel that the people who are here at this time particularly definitely are more appreciative of the methodology behind building Cardano. Now, that is not to say that when Cardano goes back up to like, you know, a dollar, or it rocks up to $2 in the next bull run or something like that, oh, it's going to be, you know, the community will change as does during the bull market. I think the bear market, though, is where real community, like that bedrock of community, is really built. And I feel like that's what Cardano's got right now in terms of a community. A lot of really passionate people who are big enthusiasts of the methodology behind Cardano.
That's a great response. Thank you, Lark. And I wanted to segue maybe into another question. I mean, you mentioned that different communities are at different stages. You know, you go into certain Reddits or you go into certain Telegrams and the mentality is different. I know in the Cardano community, a lot of people are speaking about the tech and they're excited about the future. And of course, you know, it's an investment at the end of the day. So people are looking to get returns, of course, but there are ways to go around it. Some people are looking to 1 million X their money, and other people are more interested in the process. And when that comes, it'll come. But, as far as you, what are your long-term plans? As far as we're speaking about, we just spoke about long-term adoption and what it's going to look like in a few years. You know, I take you as more of a hodler type, but do you plan to do you want to exist within these ecosystems long-term? Is it like you're looking forward to the day where you can live, breathe, and eat certain cryptocurrencies, like transact within that ecosystem? Is that what you're looking for? Or is it more like, you know, I have this exit point and I'm going to leave at this point? Or is it something more long-term for you?
It depends on the cryptocurrency, to be honest. And that's a great question. Because for me, some cryptocurrencies, I'm in them just, I'm going to cash out at some point. Some of them I actually plan on using at some point. You know, I could say, I was actually thinking about this in the shower, ironically, earlier. And I was thinking about my Power Ledger investment. And I was thinking, literally, I'm literally going to hold on to my Power Ledger investment until one of two things happen. One, I can use it to trade power peer-to-peer here in New Zealand, which they're working with power company here, so it might be a possibility in the near future. Or I'll use it to invest in one of their asset germination events to literally invest in the future of renewable energy, right? So for me, there's quite a few of my cryptos that are exactly like this. And Cardano is one of those as well, that I'm holding on to this for that future when there's a very big and thriving dApp ecosystem. I can be using different applications and, you know, paying in Cardano, whatever it might be. And so that's definitely, for me, one of those kind of really long-term things. And obviously, I'm looking forward to staking. That's going to be great. And I've been, you know, trying to accumulate during this down market. So I've got, you know, more to stake later, which would be great. But then that kind of provides that residual amount of Cardano that you can have to play with in terms of the dApp ecosystem, investing in different ICOs that come out on Cardano and things like this. So definitely that long-term play with quite a few of my crypto investments. Again, there are some that are just, they're going to get flipped at some point. And that's okay too. That's okay too, because, you know, you pass it off to someone who might believe in that more or sees a value in investing or whatever it might be. But definitely at some point, I really want to use the cryptocurrencies in a very fruitful kind of way. And I've done that before. I actually went to, I did a 72-hour trip in Australia traveling only on Bitcoin. So, you know, trying to prove it, but it's really niche at the moment in terms of day-to-day application.
Were you able to actually do it? You traveled 72 hours spending only Bitcoin?
There was a couple of situations when it wasn't possible. Once the local Wi-Fi tower was down, or the internet cell tower was down. And so the restaurant where I was trying to pay for lunch, they're like, yeah, there's no internet right now anywhere. And so I was getting off their Wi-Fi on my phone. And so I wasn't able to pay in that one situation. There was, you know, another situation with one of the hotels where like the lady's like, oh, I've already cashed out for the night and you'll just have to pay tomorrow morning. And I was like, well, I'm leaving at like 5 a.m. You guys are home until 9 or whatever at reception. And she's like, well, we'll just charge your credit card then, because we have it on file, because you had to do that for your, you know, deposit. So, you know, most of the time, I'd say about 90-95% of the things that I wanted to pay for in Bitcoin I was successful in doing, which was pretty cool.
Wow, that's a lot higher rate than I would have thought. I might not have attempted to do that. Plus, I'm also not tempted because I'd be like, well, I might spend this right now for $5, but next year it might be worth $50. So I do I really want to spend it right now doing that?